Barack and Michelle screw taxpayers on Malia's big secret that they don't want you to know. A new, shocking report has just surfaced, and many American taxpayers are feeling screwed as Barack and Michelle Obama continue to spend our hard-earned money. As we all know, the former first couple's daughter, Malia, was working for the now-disgraced movie mogul Harvey Weinstein, who was facing allegations of sexually harassing and even raping young Hollywood starlets. Now, Barack and Michelle are caught spending unwarranted taxpayer dollars on another big secret about Malia that they don't want you to know. With so many Americans still struggling to make ends meet, questions about what type of taxpayer dollars are being spent on the Obamas have come to the forefront. Barack Obama's failed economic policies left America devastated. As Fox News reports, the last 8 years, under Obama, have brought the lowest labor participation rates since the 1970s, with 95 million Americans out of the labor force. So, it's no wonder Americans are asking how much do the Obamas cost us in taxpayer dollars now they are out of office. While we know former presidents all have Secret Service for life, Americans wanted to know, do their extended family get protection for life too? For many, it came as a shocker that while Barack Obama was president, he enacted new guidelines for the children and extended family members of former presidents. H.R. 6620, the former President's Protection Act of 2012, also gives Secret Service protection to former first ladies and guarantees agents will continue to shadow children of former presidents until they become 16 years of age, reported ABC News. But, there's more. In addition, AOL News reports, while at least one report from August said that the former president's eldest daughter will have a Secret Service detail, the move would be an exception to a bill former President Barack Obama himself signed into law more than 4 years ago. The legislation restored lifetime Secret Service protection for former presidents, first ladies, and children of former presidents until they become 16 years of age. It was just learned that Barack and Michelle were fed up with how Malia's recent behavior has reflected on them, and they demanded Secret Service for her 24/7 as she went to Harvard. Since the Obamas' net worth is somewhere upwards of $40-60 million, Americans wondered, why can't they pay for it themselves? In essence, it's not about her safety as much as her behavior, so it sounds like she doesn't need Secret Service as much as she needs a babysitter. And American taxpayers simply shouldn't have to foot that bill. No one wants to see anyone put in danger, but Obama camp insiders have said that Barack and Michelle are used to having their way paid for and they did not want to spend their money on Malia's so-called protection. Rumors started circulating from inside Washington, D.C., that after Malia went to New York on her own to work for Weinstein, thanks to mom and dad, they were livid when their eldest daughter made Page Six and was featured on TMZ looking high and drunk. So, again, is this really about safety anyway? Trouble started back in 2016 when Malia was caught allegedly smoking pot at a concert. The daughter of U.S. President Barack Obama is facing claims she was smoking cannabis at a music festival after a video emerged of Malia Obama appearing to take a drag from a slim cigarette, reported The Sun. Things quickly escalated when Malia went to live in New York on her own. Of course, we now know she was working in the midst of a sexual predator, Harvey Weinstein, and we know her parents were all too aware of Mr. Weinstein's sexually harassing young girls. Most of Malia's behavior was reported as just a teenager being a teenager, that is until she looked passed out in a golf cart at a concert in August 2017. The driver was a Secret Service agent, and she was being carted out of the venue quickly. Most parents would be out of their minds seeing that footage, but insiders claim the Obamas were too busy living it up on yachts and vacationing with Hollywood celebrities to take much notice. Radio host Laura Ingraham, who has been a Washington insider for over 25 years, speculated that Barack and Michelle are so ambitious that their daughters are ornaments reflecting the greatness of Barack and Michelle and thus must not get out of line. Ever. We feel sorry for the Obama girls, but we know Malia was not going to have Secret Service until her parents were upset about her behavior from last August. Last year, The Washington Post wrote that for Malia, The decision to delay school 1 year may mean she will not have to be accompanied by the Secret Service contingent that would be required if she had begun college immediately. That was the plan as she left high school in 2016. So, in essence, the gap year she took, in part, was so Secret Service agents wouldn't have to accompany her to Harvard. However, that all changed after she embarrassed mom and dad. It seems like the Obamas are using the Secret Service as surrogate parents or at the very least personal babysitters as a band-aid to cover up Malia's issues and their poor parenting. We truly feel sorry for Malia Obama, with Barack and Michelle as her absentee parents, more worried about themselves than their children, who wouldn't. We hope she stays safe, but we think it is her parents who should be more involved with her in providing their own security detail for their daughter. It's time they took on that responsibility since it's better for Malia and, of course, it's better for the American taxpayers. Bayers.